And we start this afternoon with high-speed trains, and China's been making big investments in this area. From a single track in 2007, today they have 25,000 kilometers of high-speed rail. Trains traveling up to 350 kilometers per hour transport 1.4 billion passengers per year, and in Shanghai alone, a high-speed train goes through the main train station every 84 seconds. So to talk to us about the innovations in high-speed rail in China, please welcome to the stage Mr. Zhang from CRRC and Mr. Louis from CyberInsights, a engineering firm that's working with them. Gentlemen.
Hi.
Ni hao.
Ni hao. Ni hao.
Now, for you in the audience, Mr. Zhang will be speaking through an interpreter. Mr. Zhang, please tell us about CRRC.
Yeah. 中车青岛四方机车车辆股份有限公司 是中国最大的高速动车组整车生产厂商。轨道交通车辆产品出口超过20个国家和地区。我们正在制造的列车能够为乘客提供更安全、更绿色、更愉快的乘车体验。CRRC
Qingdao Sifang Corporation Limited is one of the largest manufacturers of high-speed EMU train in China. We product in over 20 countries. We are building trains that to provide safer, greener, and more comfortable experience for passengers.
我们憧憬未来的轨道交通将超越城际、跨越国界，极大地改善世界各地之间的沟通与交流。Our
vision for the future goes far beyond intercity travel, pushing the boundary of what's possible and improving mobility between borders, continents, and people.
Let's take a look at a short video.
Gorgeous train. 要实现这样的愿景，其中的重点方向之一是列车的维护，预测性维护只在必要的条件下进行维护。这样的改变将帮助我们的列车运营更加高效、更加经济。So
one area of focus to realize this vision is in-train maintenance. Moving to a predictive method where we service the train in advance to optimize maintenance schedules will help us run journeys more efficiently and more economically.
我们开发了一个高速动车组故障预测与健康管理系统，即PHM系统，能够实现实时监控列车核心部件轴向轴承的运行状态，并使用算法对故障进行诊断和预测。
We are developing a Prognostic and Health Management System, or PHM system, for a high-speed train that will monitor axle box bearing, a train's core component, in real time, and apply advanced analytics to diagnose and predict faults before they happen.
Now, Mr. Liu, you're working on this PHM system with CRRC. Can you lead us through the architecture of the system?
Yeah, sure, I'd love to. The entire system can be broken down into data acquisition, edge computing, onboard PHM system, and a ground research center. And with multiple sensors on each bearing, and each needing the high speed and the synchronized data acquisition, plus 16 channels of vibration data on each car. And this application will soon generate a lot of data. But luckily, with the computational power we borrow from the compact rail, we can actually use the edge computing node to process the data into useful features in field before we send them out to the remote server. And this can help us reduce the streaming from hundreds of megabytes per second to just a few kilobytes per second, which was great to us.
Yeah, and I know this operation is really sophisticated. Trying to pick out the signal of interest in a really noisy environment like this is like trying to listen to a whispered conversation at a rock concert, right?
Yeah, exactly right. So the vibration signature we are looking for can be barely felt by hand, and yet we're competing with the large background noise generated by a hundreds of tons train traveling at 350 kilometers per hour. Therefore, we need to develop algorithms that can isolate and enhance the fault features. So as we know, the fault features can be quite complicated in order to diagnose the failure mode, and we use the machine learning algorithms that we developed. Those algorithms can help us identify more than 20 different failure characteristic patterns so that we can diagnose the failure mode on the bearing, which may be the auto race, inner race, roller, or cage damage, and also the level of damage in order to trigger different levels of maintenance and the work order.
Yeah, and like we said, this is a very sophisticated system, but you've created a very elegant user interface for your engineers, and I don't speak Chinese, but I think I might even be able to use it. Can you share that with the audience?
Yeah, sure. So this is an interface that engineers in CRRC Qingdao Sifang are looking at, and we can see all the bearings being tested with colors indicating the health status of the bearing. And if we click on one of the bearing, we can see all the detailed analysis behind the alarm. And in this case, the harmonic intensity at the outer race failure characteristic frequency is higher, which means that the bearing is likely to have a outer race damage. So what do you think, Mr. Zhang?
这样的技术对我们的团队来说是非常有价值的。我们将持续不断地投入到PIM系统的研发工作。 未来将延伸到转向架、牵引、制动、车体、车门等系统，以更加经济的维护成本实现更加高效的运行。这同时为未来洲际列车的运行奠定了基础。
So technology like this is a real help to my team. We have plans to continue to develop and invest in PHM system for high-speed rail, expanding it to the bogie, traction system, car body, brakes, doors, and more, enabling more efficient operations while reducing maintenance costs. This will lay the foundation for intercontinental travel in the future.
Wow, intercontinental rail travel, think about that. You could be sitting on that gorgeous train all the way from Beijing to London, and think about the all the xiaolongbao you can eat on the way. So now, Mr. Liu, I know you're working to take this PHM system and move it to other industries. What kind of challenges do you anticipate having as you attempt this expansion?
Energy, manufacturing, large machineries, and renewable energies, like all those industries and more are looking for PHM solutions. The solution requests are not only more varied, but more complex due to the expectations for the insights from the prognostic system is growing. And therefore, in order to meet those demands, and we need a reliable and a scalable data backbone to help us gather data easily from all kinds of sources so that we can concentrate on what we are good at, which are the algorithm development and full system integration.
Yeah, which makes perfect sense. I mean, your expertise is in algorithm development, and ideally you could have an off-the-shelf solution that feeds data to those algorithms. Well, as it turns out, we've got an exciting announcement later in this keynote that will satisfy that need, so please stay tuned. And I appreciate you guys coming from China. 谢谢.
Thank you.